together tonight. Sing this with me. Just any day now, our Lord is coming. He'll be returning for you and me. Oh, I've been watching, and I have been just any day now, our Lord is coming. He'll be returning, you and me, for you and me. For I've been watching, and I have tonight, just any day now, our Lord is coming. He's already came and he's still coming. Praise the Lord. We have a few written requests. When we continue to remember Sister Judith, Brother Allen, Sister Carolyn, Sister Debbie, we're just going to keep praying until God moves for us tonight. Amen. Also, I think Sister Ashley Franklin has been admitted to the hospital with some stomach issues, and we just want to remember her in our prayers tonight. God is mindful of each one of these requests tonight. And I'm sure you have something on your heart as well. If you just make that known by an uplifted hand, God sees all of our needs tonight in this very service. May have brought a brother all the way from Ghana to tell us what we have need of tonight. How many believe God can do that? Amen. He knows what's going on, don't he? Amen. God bless you. Brother Jonathan, why don't you come and lead us in prayer tonight?
Come to have church done. Amen. Everything we have need of is laying before us. Amen. Let's just honor him. Heavenly Father, Lord. Lord, once again, Lord, we come as a group of people, Lord. Lord, burdened by trials, Lord, burdened by situations, Lord, and in and out of work and around, Lord, demonic powers all day. But Lord, we sit aside a place, Lord. We sit aside a time, Lord, that we can draw into your bosom, Lord. We can draw close to you. Lord, as we gather tonight, Lord, and I ask you, Lord, to move amongst us, Lord Jesus. I ask you to move for our sick, Lord Jesus, that you could touch them, Lord, and just completely bring healing power to them. You say, Lord, you're moving. Oh, he's already moving. But Lord, bring completely healing touches to them, Lord. Those that lifted their hands, Lord, you see the needs they have tonight, Lord. You see mine as well, Lord. I ask you to bless this group of people tonight, Lord. Those that are online, Lord. Bless Brother Mark, Lord. Bless Brother Samson, Lord. Let them just preach, Lord, and just speak the words of eternal life through the service, Lord. Lord, grant it, Lord, in your lovely name we pray. Amen and amen.
Aren't you thankful for Wednesday night service? Amen. I'm sure you've had a day just like the rest of us. But guess what? Through it all, I've learned to trust in Jesus. Amen. Why don't we sing that together tonight? Give G. G.
Oh, through it all. Yes, I've learned to trust in God through it all, through it all. Yes, I've learned to depend upon his word. Well, I've had many tears questions for tomorrow. There have been times that I didn't know right from wrong. But in every situation, God gave blessed consolation that my trials, they only come to make. Oh, aren't you thankful for your trials tonight? Oh, that's why it's through it all. Oh, through it all. I've learned to trust in Jesus. Yes, I've learned. I've learned to trust in God. Yes, I thank Him for every storm He's brought me through. For if I never had a problem, I would know that God can solve them. I'd never know just what faith in His Word could do. Yes, I've learned to trust in God through it all. Oh, through it all. Yes, I've learned to depend upon His Word. Oh, yes, I've learned to depend upon
have to depend on tonight except the Word of God. That's what defeats Satan in every circumstance is the Word of God. Praise the Lord. Oh, and my faith is in You, Lord. My faith is in You. My faith is in You. My goal, my faith is in You, Lord. My faith is in You. One more time. Yes, my faith is in You, Lord. My faith is in You. My faith is in You, Lord. Just to carry my goal, my faith is in You, Lord. My faith is in You. Amen. Aren't you glad that your faith is in Him tonight? Amen. We have nothing else to have faith in except the Lord Jesus tonight. Amen. Trials here are sometimes many, and oft times my feet grow weary, till it seems I almost stumble, then I fall. But the tender hand that leads me is a hand that keeps me steady, and I know that I'm gonna make it after all. Do you believe it tonight? Let's say it. Oh, after all this life is over. Hallelujah. Oh, and all my burdens, they have been lifted. But I know that He's there to help me, and He will hear my prayer if I will only call. So just keep trusting and believing. These are the words that I hear Him whisper, and just a few more days to labor. Aren't you glad about that? After all, hallelujah. Oh, after all this life, hallelujah. Think about that. Oh, and all of my burdens, they have been lifted. Keep getting a glimpse of that city. Oh, that'll give us faith to press on tonight, won't it? Praise the Lord. Amen. And in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, we have victory. Yes, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, all the demons, for when we stand in the name of Jesus, tell me who can stand before in that precious name of Jesus. Oh, we have the victory. Oh, aren't you glad we have the victory? Yes, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, I have the victory. I have the victory. Oh, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, all the demons will have to flee.
the bed. Oh, one more time, in the name of Jesus. Yes, in the name of Jesus. Oh, in the name of Jesus. Oh, I have the victory. Yes, oh, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. All the demons, they'll have to flee. For when I stand in the name of Jesus, in that precious name of Jesus, oh, I have the victory.
Tell me, when we stand in the name of Jesus, who or what can stand before us? Amen. Amen. Think about that. I ought to make you happy tonight. In the name of Jesus. We're here in the name of Jesus tonight. Praise the Lord. Amen. You can have your seats. We'll have our ushers to come and receive the eating offering, and you just give to the Lord. Brother Jim's good to have you with us tonight, buddy. We love you. God bless you. Amen. Let's sing this kid, Jim.
Oh, greater is he that is in me. Greater is he that is in me. Greater. A roaring lion is roaming to and fro, seeking who he may devour. The Bible tells us so, and many souls have been his prey to fall in some weak.
Test and every trial, if we could just realize that greater is he that's in me than this trial. Praise the Lord. God is good tonight, isn't he? One more song, we'll have Brother Ben come tonight.
Well, I'm in this church. It's a glorious church. I did not join it. I was born. I've had a new birth. Some glorious thing gonna sail away. I'm in this church. Oh, I'm in this church. It's the glorious church. I did not join it. I was born and had a new birth.
by his grace, not by my works. Praise God. By his grace. Thank the Lord. Amen. Come ahead, Brother Bingley. You want to? Yeah. Can we practice a little bit with you tonight? I've faced a mountain I've never faced before. That's why I'm calling on you, Lord. I know it's been a while, but Lord, please hear my prayer. I need you like I never have before. Sometimes it takes a mountain. Don't want to do that tonight. Oh, sometimes just the troubled sea. Sometimes it takes a desert to get a hold of me. Lord, your love is so much stronger than whatever troubles me. Sometimes it takes a mountain to trust you and believe. Forgive me, Jesus. I thought I could control whatever life would throw my way. Oh, but this, I will admit, has brought me to my knees. I need you, Lord, and I'm not ashamed to say. Sometimes it takes a mountain. Oh, sometimes a troubled sea. Sometimes it takes a desert to get a hold of me. To get a hold of me. Lord, your love is so much stronger, yes, sir, than whatever troubles me. Oh, sometimes it takes a mountain. Sometimes it takes a mountain. Oh, yes. To trust you and believe. Takes a mountain. Sometimes a troubled sea. Sometimes it takes a desert to get a hold of me.
Oh, but your love is so much stronger.
Love is so much stronger than whatever troubles me. So sometimes it takes a night.
mountain. Sometimes the troubles seem. Sometimes it takes a desert to get a hold of me. But I like this. Your love is so much stronger than whatever troubles me. Sometimes it takes a mountain, oh, yes it does, to trust you and believe.
Oh, why don't you sing that with us one more time?
Sometimes it takes a mountain.
Oh, yes.
Sometimes it's a troubled sea. Sometimes it takes a desert to get a hold.
Believe it, say amen.
Your love is so much stronger.
Sometimes you got to shake me. You got to put me on my back. He has to do a lot of things to us. But whatever it takes, Lord, to get a hold of me, Lord, do it. Why don't we just stand and just give the Lord a good hand clap of praise tonight.
Praise the Lord.
Oh, praise the Lord. I'm so glad that he got a hold of me. Aren't you glad that he got you tonight? Praise the Lord, Jesus. Hallelujah. He's worthy of our praise tonight. Amen. Praise the Lord. Man, I just wish song service could go on for about another hour, don't you? You get to feeling this good. But the reason we have song service is to get our souls all tore up and get ready for the planting of the seed of the Word of God. Amen. And may we just bring forth fruit tonight 100-fold. I'm looking forward to what God has in store for us. Amen. I know he's got a stockpile just waiting on us tonight. Amen. I just want to sing this chorus before we invite our brother to come. You know, one can chase 1,000, but 2 and 10 can chase 10,000 tonight. So if we'll just band together tonight and run Satan out of this town tonight, praise the Lord. Amen. Let's sing this in the key of G. G.
You're my brother, you're my sister. So take me by the hand.
Together we can work.
Together we will work until he comes. that can defeat us when we're walking side by side. Long as there's love, long as there is love, we will stand. Oh, let's sing it together. Yes, you're my brother, you're my sister. So take by the hand. Together we will work until He comes. There is no foe that can defeat us when we're walking side by side. As long as there is love, we will stand.
Thank you, Lord. Event that has happened, that has been prophesied through the course of history, through the centuries before us, to be a part of this great drama and event of this last day. How humble I feel tonight. I heard the prophet crying out 5 messages before his accident, crying out in Shreveport under the Holy Spirit to the bride of Christ. Here he is in Brother Jack Moore's church. You know, Brother Jack never really seen a message. It went right over his head. Serpent seed, he couldn't see it. And here's the prophet bringing his final climax message to the bride of Christ. How blessed we are. You know, I love this message with all my heart, my soul, and my mind. My wife and I, some 25 years ago, we held hands together. We started a small work for the Lord. We decided if it was just us and our family, we will follow this to the end. It is the absolute of this day. I heard Brother Branham just crying out today, and he went from the message, "I've heard, but now I see." And he goes to the next message, "God's only provided place of worship." And he's tearing down every denominational walls, and he's crying out to the bride of Christ. I thought, oh God, I love this word with all my heart. I love this truth that God has given me. He said this. He said, if I go in this generation, may the people who believe this message never stand still for denomination. Oh, you'll die right in your track. Remember that. The very hour that you mention denomination amongst you, I don't care how sincere you are, take a man for your leader instead of the Holy Spirit to confirm His word. Oh, that's the hour you will die. Oh, may God help us. He has drawn us away from Babylon. Hallelujah. We've come out of Babylon. Like Abraham on the backside of the desert. We may not be a large number. We may not be big in numbers. But in our heart, we possess the very bloodline of Jesus Christ tonight. In us flow the royal blood. Hallelujah. I'm so glad and thankful to be a part of it. I feel so humble, Brother Carey, to be a part of this. So blessed to be a part of this. I think of the little song, "I'm going through. I'm going through." Amen. I take the way where the Lord despised you. I started out with Jesus, and I'm going through. I'm determined. I'm determined. Such great men of God that give their lives, give themselves to bring us such great truths. How blessed we are today. So happy to have each and every one of you in the house of the Lord. So very, very thankful and privileged to have a very special guest with us in our gates. Was here with us on Sunday worship with us, Brother Samson and Sister Comfort Tate. And all the way from Accra, Ghana, pastors of church there in Ghana, a very, very wonderful group of people. I'll tell you this about Brother Samson. He's no novice. He's been an established pastor for many years. Has a very, very wonderful group of people there. I know numbers doesn't mean anything, but I wouldn't even tell you the amount of people he has in his church. It's like a sea of people there, and
He has been around the world. God has used him in the early formative years of my ministry. And I worked with Brother Harold Hildebrandt out in Edmonton. We crossed paths, and our roots go way back. And so we're very, very honored to have the elder here of Ghana. I call him the elder of Ghana. Amen. He's the elder of Ghana. There's many Ghanaian friends that I have, but I consider Brother Samson Tate to be the elder of Ghana. So we'd like to welcome him to speak for us tonight. Very humble that he will come to our little small congregation to speak tonight when he pastors literally thousands of people who has come under his ministry. But we so are grateful that he will come to speak for us tonight, and we appreciate him so much. Brother Ben just spoke their convention there in Ghana, a wonderful people. He's eyewitness of the work there that God is doing. So we're in good company. We're in good company and fellowship here tonight. So let's turn our hearts to the word tonight. How many of you just come tonight to just want God to speak to you? I told my wife today, I'm just so in love with the Lord Jesus Christ. I just love him every day. I just love him every day. Whatever years he has for me left on this life, let me just love my Jesus. Every day, let me serve him. Let me just give my life for him. Let me give everything that I have for him. He's the love of my life. Nothing else matter. No substance matter here. All is going to perish. All may fail, but Jesus never. Glory to his name. Oh, how blessed we are. I want to thank you too also for the kind gathering that you had on Sunday for me, and for coming out and your support. And we thank you and all the gifts that you've given and the kind words and cards that you've given to me. Thank you so much, gift cards and all of that. May the Lord bless you and replenish you a hundredfold. We certainly appreciate the token of your love to us. And most of all, I appreciate you serving the God that I love so much, Jesus Christ. Amen. If you ever want to do anything for me, you love Brother Joseph, I can't come across your mind. Say, you know what, that brother loves the Lord. I want to serve the God he serves. He's a living Jesus Christ. Let's turn the order of the service now as we change the order. Like for us to just put our minds on the Lord and allow God to speak to us tonight. Tonight you're going to witness a supernatural miraculous. A brother that came thousands of miles across the water. And you will see the gift of God operate like it operated in the book of Acts. This is why we're not a denomination, because it's supernatural. You will see him get anointed and drop in a channel of the Holy Spirit and go down into your lives and speak things that you spoke of today. That's why we're not a denomination. We don't send out a memo, and we don't send out some chart of what's going to happen. God directs the man of God. And even though he comes all the way from across the water, I believe tonight he will come right in the channel tonight and speak to every life tonight. Only believe all things are possible, as our precious brother Samson Tay, elder and servant of God, comes to speak to us tonight. God bless you.
Before our brother comes, can we just give our pastor a hand tonight? Tomorrow is actually his birthday. Let's give him a big hand for his birthday.
God bless you. Amen. Only believe all things are possible. Amen.
Only believe. Only believe. All things are.
Tell him, Lord, I believe tonight. If you will sing it with all your heart,
yes, Lord, I believe.
Yes, Lord, I believe.
Oh, Lord, I believe all things are possible, Lord. I Oh Lord, I believe. Yes, Lord, I believe that all things are possible. Lord, I believe.
Amen. Shall we bow down our heads? Precious Heavenly Father, we bow before Thee tonight because there's none like unto Thee. You are before all things, and after Thee there is none. You are the El Ella Elohim. How we appreciate Thee. We exalt Your holy name and we magnify Thee. Dear Lord, Your children are in Your presence. We are not gathered around a man, but we are gathering around Your very presence unto Your bride this end time. We pray Thee, O God, that You have the full preeminence. Take control, Lord, that these few words we want to put together will be a blessing to Your people, will take us to more closer walk with You. We ask this grace in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. Shall we be seated? Well, very happy to be with you tonight, and I bring special greetings across the Atlantic Ocean to believers right down here, and I want to plead with you, sometimes the accent may not be just like you speak it, but I want you to take me for what I mean. Not for what I say. Amen. And I hope that God will make you understand what the really thought we want to speak about tonight. Well, back in Africa, we are still in revival. And we believe this revival will not stop until we meet Him in the air. It is a great time in the presence of the Lord. God is adding to the church every day. Amen. And our brother Jeff is doing very good at the north part of our country. That is the primitive part of the country, where very hot area. People don't like going there. But Jeff is so strong. He's always among them and doing a very good job there. I really appreciate the young man. Amen. We are getting old now. They are the young men coming up. But in the south, by God's grace, we're still moving. And God is adding to the church, and revival fires everywhere. Of late, what I'm seeing the Lord doing, which is, to me, is a very powerful and a quick work, is people stay in their home somewhere, and they sometimes dream, or sometimes they hear a voice, and that will direct them to come to the church immediately. And to me, that is a very great something. Yes, one sister in another city, maybe 20 to 30 miles away. You know, Africa, when you say 30 miles, it's big than here because majority don't have cars. And so they look it long. But he said he had a voice spoke to him, just go to the Message of Grace Tabernacle. That was my church. And he begins searching for, he's not getting it. Over a week, then he met somebody. When he asked him, so, oh, yes, that is Nashama, I can show you the place. And he came down to church. To me, that's a great move of God. God gathering His children at this very hour. After all, what are we waiting for? The last bride member. When he comes in, then we go. And the prophet said it could be a black sheep. And so we're looking for them. And when we get there, we leave this place and go to be with the Lord. Amen. I believe we are in an age where the prophet said we need more faith than any other age. He said because it's going to take a rapture in faith. The going home of the bride. That not just a single man like Enoch or like Elijah, but a whole people across the globe. In a moment, in the twinkle of an eye, and they will be changed. Defiled death to meet our Lord in the air. So it takes more faith than any other faith. Yes. And I believe that is the message we are preaching. Yes. The rapturing faith is in the message of the hour. Amen. Amen. So we want to play thieves a little. We are still praying thieves because we're saying what the prophet said. Yes. Amen. Amen. So let's quickly turn our Bible. We didn't have time tonight. Anyway. To the book of Ruth. Chapter 1, and I read verse 6, and then I jump to 14, to 17, then to 22. The book of Ruth, chapter 1, verse 6. Then she arose with her daughter-in-law, that he might return from the country of Moab, for she had heard in the country of Moab how that the Lord had visited his people in giving them bread. Then I will jump to 14. And he lifted up their voice and wept again. And Orpah kissed her mother-in-law, but Ruth craved unto her. And he said, behold, thy sister-in-law is gone back unto her people. Unto her gods, return thou after thy sister-in-law. And Ruth said, entreat me not to leave thee, or to return from following after thee. For whither thou goest, I will go. And where thou lodgest, I will lodge. Thy people shall be my people, and thy God my God. Where thou diest, will I die? And there will I be buried. Yes, Lord. The Lord do so with me, and more also, if out but death part thee and me. Amen. Then I'll read 22, verse 22. So Naomi returned and ruled the Moabitish, her daughter-in-law with her, which returned out of the land of Moab, and they came to Bethlehem in the beginning of the barley harvest. May the Lord add his blessing to the word. Shall we be seated? Amen. My little subject tonight. Back home, I preached it about 3 times, but I'll try to hold it simply tonight. Amen. Barley harvest. The full redemption. Barley harvest, full redemption. Amen. Like our pastor is saying right here, we are part of the fulfillment of scriptures of this end time. We're not just ordinary church members, but we are special people that God has predestinated us to do a special work at this very hour. And we are the part of the fulfillment. Yes. Individually, we are fulfilling scripture. Yes, right. We're not living a life of our own. Yes, right. But the things that the prophet have seen afar off, yes, and was spoken, we are now in the manifestation. Yes. There has never been an age like this age, right, and never shall it be. Right. This is the best age you could ever think of. Right. But Abraham said, because this is the golden age. Yes. Because everything is coming to its fulfillment. Yes. Amen. And we are not just ordinary church members. I want that to sink in. Amen. We are special people. Yes. With a special ministry. Yes. Amen. That the whole generations, they are looking and waiting for us. Yes. For they without us are not perfect. Yes. We're living in the age of the perfection. Yes. Now let's look at this subject a little bit. Pray that I'm not going to say new things. I'm just reminding you things you have heard and you know. Yes. Amen. Because the same Holy Spirit moving here, I believe, is moving in Africa. Yes. Amen. The only difference is Africa, we are not harvesting. All right. So we have a bigger churches. But here you are doing greening. And so you don't have it enough like we are having it back there. And I invite all of you to come and visit Africa. Amen. Now we see it was in a time of famine that pushed Naomi and his family out of Palestine. In the time of famine, things were not getting well. The same as it happened in the church ages, when the Jews rejected Jesus Christ, they entered into famine. And it's right there they were kicked out of their land and they moved out into the nations. Amen. Now, when they went, it wasn't good for them. They went, Naomi, present. And he went and he came back, Mara. Things were not good down there. He lost the husband, he lost the two sons. And he heard of a message that God is now visiting his people. It's a time to return home. And then he began to prepare to go. But he had two daughter-in-laws. The men were all gone, remaining the women. So that type of church. To come back. So he was doing everything to get them to go back. Now I'm going to look at these three women. That is Naomi, Ruth, and Orpah. And I'm going to look at them from the seals. Because Brother Abraham said the seals identify from Genesis to Revelation. The book of Ruth is the only Gentile book. And it wasn't a man, it was a female. Because we Gentiles, we come in as a bride. So that's the only book, and it talks about redemption. Amen. Of a Gentile lady. He's speaking directly to us. It is a prophecy concerning us in the life of Ruth and Naomi and Orpah. So I want to look at these three women. And I look at them and I saw that when the seals were open, it revealed three ministries. The ministry of the Antichrist, the ministry of the Jews, and the ministry of Christ and the bride. The ministry of the Antichrist, the first four seals. The white horse, the red horse, black horse, and the pale horse, which we know is in manifestation now. Then the fifth and the sixth is the Jewish seal. Amen. Which is the sixth seal. They are waiting for their two prophets to restore them back home. Then the seventh seal is the invincible union. Christ and his church. So we see these three women are holding these three ministries, which of course it is the three main revivals in this end time. The revival of the old Roman Empire. They are returning back to Rome. The revival of the Jewish people going back to their homeland. And the revival of the bride, which we call it the bride age. We also have a revival. And all this is in the seals. Amen. Now we see here that Naomi began to convince them to return. And Orpah returned. Orpah, now we can see him in the fourth seal. A spirit of going back. According to Naomi, he told Ruth he has returned to his people. He has returned to his idols. Amen. Now, Orpah here, we could look at it under the fourth seal. Amen. God have mercy. Under the fourth seal, under the vows, three unclean spirits were loose. And Brother Abraham said they were here all the time, but they were not working until the seventh seal was open. And see, these three unclean spirits like frogs. And he said, if you look at the nature of frog, he looks back when he's going forward. And he said, that spirit is loose, is poured out, and is calling people back to Rome. Calling back. Now we can see this spirit under the ministry of Saul and David. It was so plain down there. Saul was the people's man. He was anointed by the same prophet. But the Bible says he was anointed out of a vow. But David was anointed out of horn. So there was a horn anointing and there was a vial anointing. We realize Saul, when he came to power, he chased the witches all over the place. He was fighting against them. He was even called one of the prophets, among the prophets. But before he ended his ministry, he went back to the witch of Endor. So there's a spirit of retaining, looking back. The thing that he stood against, he turned around and goes to unite with it. If that is not a spirit today, things that we stood against, when we came into this message, we see people going back to them. People buying televisions and things. Things that they spoke against some time past, today they said it's nothing. A spirit of looking back. And that was a spirit upon Saul. He returned back to the witch of Endor. And it is a serious spirit. I think this end time Jesus made mention of it. When you read Luke 17, when he was talking about two shall be on the bed, one taking the other, one left, and talking, then he stopped and he said, remember Lot's wife. Why did he drop Lot's wife there? It's a spirit of looking back. And no wonder we saw in the message. People who pastored 33 years, now they said the message is not true. It's a spirit calling them back. So the question is, where is your anointing? Is it a vial anointing or a horn anointing? Because in Revelations, you saw the Lamb with seven horns. Is that right? And that's the Lord Jesus Christ. And he also poured anointing under the seals. So David was under the anointing of a horn. Oh, we don't have time to break into horns. I hope you know them already, so there's no need of going back. Amen. But David was anointed under the horn. The oil was poured into a horn before poured onto him. But Saul, it was poured into a vial. And when the vials were loose, this spirit was released. Right in the system we are living in. The revival of the old Roman Empire is going back to their mother. That is the anointing release. But Abraham said this anointing was there, but until the seals were open, then they were loose. So when the bride was on her revival, there is another revival of the old Roman Empire. And we saw upper under that anointing. He tasted of the good things. He married a Jew. He heard of Jehovah. He knew how good Jehovah was. But she returned to her idols. And the prophet said, there's nothing you can do but anointing that is upon you. He said, you respond to anointing. Oh man, you walk on the street and you see people, you wonder how can a Russia being be doing what they are doing. But it's anointing upon their life. That is why Paul, when he met Ephesians, said, unto what were you baptized? And when he showed in the right baptism, he said, you need the Holy Ghost. If the Holy Ghost doesn't come into your life, oh brother, there's no way you can do it. There is anointing in the system. Very strong religious spirit. Moving everywhere. You don't have the baptism of the Holy Ghost, you better search for it. And I used to tell my young ones back home that God is not a grandpa. He doesn't have grandchildren. You need experience your father had. You need experience your mother had. You cannot just count on their experiences. You need to meet God face to face and know what we are talking about. The reason they are going back is because they don't have an experience. Because when you have an experience, then you agree with Paul. What can separate us from the love of God? Nothing that can separate us. We in Africa, we don't know but Abraham by the flesh. We don't know him by the flesh. It is the word we know. Yes. So we don't know that thing, but Abraham, he make a mistake, and that is not my problem. I was telling a guy who was saying, Brother Brian is making, I said, Brother, I want to ask you a question. Abraham sent Eliezer to go and bring a wife unto Isaac. He went and got Rebecca. He brought her to Isaac. Isaac took her. And then somebody running back and say, Eliezer made a mistake. What have that to do with Isaac and Rebecca? Whether I make a mistake or not, I had my husband. So it is too late now to tell me, but Abraham made a mistake, because I am now in an invincible union. I am united with Christ. So it's too late now to be finding fault. Where didn't you find it when he was alive? When you stand in Great Chicago Ministerial Association, why didn't you go down there and challenge him? Oh, man. Amen. The bride had found her Lord. It's too late now. Amen. So we see offer returned. A spirit of looking back. In the first Exodus, it happened. When they got to Kadesh Barnea, and they went to search the land. Then the 10 elders give a bad report. Right. And only Joshua and Caleb gave the true report. And that spirit took over. We want to go back to Egypt. Right. We want a leader. Yes, sir. And the Bible says God never forgave them. Amen. They all died in the wilderness. Amen. The Bible says if you put your hand into a plow to look back, you are not worthy of the kingdom. Right. We are not the people who look back. We are pressing forward. Yeah. Amen. We're not going to give up. Yeah. Amen. I tell my people back home, don't be a church member. Be baptized into the body of Christ. Church membership is over. I tell them, we don't have even register to register your names. We don't give you certificate of baptisms. All we have is the baptism of the Holy Ghost. Amen. And when your name is in the Lamb book of life, you will go all out for it. Amen. So we see offer returned. Then the next one we want to look, maybe we'll rest there a little bit, is Naomi, which is the sixth seal. The same time Naomi desiring to go back home is the same time Ruth also desiring to go back, to go with him. Because Ruth had a scripture that when your husband dies, his brother can take over to raise up a seed for your husband. And he knew staying in Moab, there will be no brother of the husband in Moab. The brother of the Moab, they are in Bethlehem. So he has something he's holding. That is why I say, I'm not returning. Amen. Naomi was looking at the other side and said, oh, you are a Gentile lady. And if you come there, nobody will care about you. But she had a promise. She had a promise. So you say, where you go, I will go. Where you die, I will die. Your God will be my God. And your people will be my people. I'm going to be part of the whole system. That is revelation. Amen. Now let's look at this. I'm just hitting the highlights. I hope you understand what I'm saying. Naomi going back, desiring to go back, which is perfect a time we are living in. The Jews, they are going back a Mara. 6 million Jews were cremated and killed under Hitler. So they were not returning with joy. But God made where they were staying no good. You better go back home. Now we are seeing things happening in our day. And I'm going to go into it a little bit. Which is the sixth seal. That is the second revival that is going on. The Jews are looking for their Messiah. Yes. And they can't get their Messiah until we finish with the Messiah. Yes. But they are looking at their Messiah. We see how that the moment the Jews got their independence, around the same time, the angel of the Lord came unto the prophet. So you see the two ministries working hand by hand. The Gentile must come in before the Jews can fully receive their Messiah. But things are happening. Now let me read a prophecy. In the 12th century, by a Jew of their retaining. You remember Daniel prophesied in Babylon? Yes, when they were in Babylon, Jeremiah didn't go into Babylon, but there was weeks. Amen. Which today we understood it. Amen. But this is a Jew called Judah ben Samuel. In the 12th century, gave some prophecies. Let's look at it. He prophesied and he said the Ottomans, which is the text, will conquer Jerusalem and rule for 8 jubilees. Then he said, on the 9th jubilee, Jerusalem will be considered as no man's land. Then the 10th jubilee, the Jews will begin returning, and that will signify their messianic end time period. And that was the prophecy. But let's see how it got fulfilled. The Ottoman Turks, they took Jerusalem in 1517. And they stayed there for 8 jubilees, which is 400 years. And that ended up in 1917. Perfectly 8 jubilees. Then from 1917 to 1967, another jubilee, Jerusalem was considered no man's land by the link of nations. Because they felt the three religions are all fighting over it, the Jews, the Christians, the Mohammedans. Amen? But at the end of the 9th, which is 1967, the Jews took Jerusalem. And when they took Jerusalem, the whole world said, we will not agree. They refused to recognize Jerusalem as their capital. But after that, the 10th Jubilee from 67 to 2017, at the end of 2017, there came in, we call him the king of the world, American president, who declared Jerusalem as the capital of the Jews. Amen. These things are not just politics. They are very serious. Amen? Now, if you go back into history, you realize General Eisenhower, do I pronounce it well? Eisenhower. That man was not even a politician. He was an ex-general. And he just rise up, he wanted to be a president. And he won. And that was the time the West and the East met. And Khrushchev moved his shoe and shake it on the table, which was fulfilling the scripture with the iron and the clay. So God took this man, Eisenhower, which means iron. And at the same time, Russia have Khrushchev, which means clay. And the two of them come together. God brought him in to fulfill the scripture. The politician didn't know what was happening, but the prophet picked it and showed to the bride that this is the fulfillment of this scripture. Amen. Now we come to another 8th time again, another president from nowhere. He wasn't a politician. He doesn't talk like a politician. But he took the power anyhow. And for a purpose. And then he quickly recognized Jerusalem. And the prophet said now in Daniel 70 weeks, he said, Matthew 24, they will throw down the walls of Jerusalem until the Gentile dispensation is finished. And when that is finished, then the Jews will return back into Jerusalem to reestablish the temple and the temple worship. They will return to establish the temple and the temple worship, which, of course, we are in the time of those things. Now, when they returned from Babylon the first time, what happened? There was a king by the name of Sapros who stood by them to be able to build the walls and restore the temple, because the Sambalat and the Tobias will not agree for the wall to be built. So there is a presidential authority behind them to build it. Are we arriving at the same time again, brothers? Because the prophet, now the president now is promising them that I will stand by you to build that. Oh man, what Iran is doing, he doesn't know what he's doing. He's joking with fire. God's word must be fulfilled. Because Naomi must come back home. Naomi must take her position. And Naomi is on her homeland now. Amen. Naomi, we are witnesses. Yes. Jerusalem. Yes, sir. Now is no more no man's land. The Jews said, this is our capital. They moved their parliament, they moved their everything right there. America moved her embassy right down there. Exactly when they were 70 years. Yes, that's when he moved it. This, everything was just in line. But when we see, we the bride, we are seeing these things, then it's telling us something. Because we need to move out of the way. Because now we have their Messiah. Amen. We have their Messiah. We have the Lord Jesus. The prophet said, my ministry is to declare to you that he is here. Amen. He's right here with the Gentile bride in the invincible union. He's right with us. Amen. He is the one we are feeding on. We are not feeding on a man. A man words will fail. But this is the unfailing body word of the Son of Man. Amen. So we see the seven seal roof moving in. And when roof moving, it's like the whole attention was on roof. Naomi began directing her what to do. Because we go back to the Bible to know what to do. The Bible is a Jewish book. If you are talking naturally, it's a Jewish book. But we know it is God's word. Amen. So Naomi have to direct roof. And he said, Naomi told roof, there's something happening. We are in the barley harvest. You go and glean and bring some food home. And this lady, no friend, nobody care about her. And when you are a real believer, you can't be friend to the world. Have nobody to talk to her. But when he went to the field and was greening, and then Boaz came to the field, he could identify her as a different lady. And he began questioning, who is that lady back there? Said, that was the Moabitess lady coming down here with Naomi. And he began giving warning. Oh, you don't have to be a Christian and be afraid. Your enemy is already warned. Your enemy is warned to be careful. Don't touch my oil and wine. Amen. The devil is warned. He can't do you nothing. Amen. Until God permit it. You are under a perfect security. There is an eye watching over you. You are not just walking alone. She didn't know. But a warning was given. Call the headman. Say, tell the young man they should be careful about that lady. Amen. When he needed food, give him. When he wants water to drink, give her. He said, you the one harvesting on her life. Drop, 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 drop the whole thing. Amazing grace. How sweet it sounds.
She didn't know he was doing her best. But grace was on her side. And I come to tell you tonight, grace is on your side. Amen. You are not just walking by yourself. Somebody is responsible for your life. Amen. You are not just an ordinary woman. You are a bride of Christ. Amen. And not just a bride, but I call you wife. You know, there's a difference between a bride and a wife. A bride is a woman in her wedding day. Is that right? And then when he comes, the father takes her and brings her in. And the pastor comes up and asks some few questions. Who gave up this woman? And he asks again, has anybody anything against it? If somebody gets up and says, that was my wife, then he can never be a wife. He entered a bride, he will return just like that. Because a pastor cannot take somebody's wife and give to somebody. But when he passed that test, amen. Then the pastor comes to them. If there's any impediment that you could not be joined together, they said there's no impediment. They said they hold her right hand. And then he pronounced them husband and wife. The moment he became wife, then you cannot break that marriage. Until death do they depart. But in our economy, it's an economy of eternity. So there's no death in our economy. So we don't care about it. It will not stop. When your name travels from the book of life to the Lamb book of life, it can never be brought away. Amen. Brother Abraham, when he was opening the seal, said, I call you bride. He said, I call you bride. But 1965, he said, you are Mrs. Jesus. Glory! Amen. He was the officiating minister. He officiated the wedding and called you a wife. So the book of Revelation says his wife has made herself ready. We are ready now to go. We are clothed with the word. Nothing can stop us. Laodicea cannot stop us. No demon can stop us. We are on our way. We will make it. Amen. The bride will never miss the rapture. It's coming for her. Oh, what a privileged people. Amen. So Ruth didn't know things were happening on her behalf. Things were being done on her behalf. Good things. And he finished that day. He packed a whole lot. He went home. Naomi said, on which field did you go and glean? He said, well, yeah, it's called Boaz. He said, that's right. You went to the right church. Amen. Don't just go to any church. But Abraham said, pray over the church before you move in. Amen. You went to the right place. Amen. He needs a kinsman. And a kinsman is not in other farms. There were other farms harvesting at the same time. But the kinsman is not there. There's only one place you can meet the kinsman. Amen. And that's where he went. The farm of Boaz. The church of the living God. Amen. That's the only place. Amen. He said, now I reveal a secret to you. Now, I'm revealing the secret. You are going to do something that is uncommon. It's not easy, but you must do that. This man knew. He is a kinsman, but he's doing nothing. So you must do something. Go to the threshing floor tonight and make sure nobody sees you. No more public show. The fat fool is not for public show. Make sure nobody sees you, but watch Boaz. He will be so happy. He will drink. He will make merry. And then he will be tired. And then he will go and sleep. Go and sleep by his feet. A revelation. But Abraham said to the bride, the rapture is a revelation. It's revealed to her the secret of Boaz. How to get Boaz. It's revealed to her. And she went to the threshing floor and was passing by covered and dodging around and looking at the man. And you see, you need to be serious with God.
That's
right. The Bible says, watch and pray. He doesn't need to go. He could have gone to sleep like any other woman. But if he failed that night, he's finished. He have to forgo. You could say, I'm tired. I'm from work. I'm tired. I can't go to church. You are not serious yet. Yeah. Naomi showed her the way to make it. And it is only tonight. He will be in the threshing floor only tonight. If you let tomorrow, we are finished. Whether you are tired or not, you need to go. Oh, like Elijah and Elisha. He said, if you see me go, then you receive your request. And Elisha has to keep awake. Amen. And watch for something to happen. And when the chariot of fire came down, he begins screaming, my father, the chariot of Israel. He wants Elijah to know that I've seen you. Then the mantle fall on him. She has to take notice. And then he rewatched Boaz, maybe drunk and was walking in the house and passing the back, and he was looking at her. And, brah. He said, man, I have my sleeping place. And she went and lied down by his feet. How can a woman do that? How can a woman do that? But sometimes you need to go to the feet of Jesus. Amen. That woman has to weep at the feet of Jesus. With the tears. Clean the feet and walk, wipe it with the hair. It's uncommon. That's why the Pharisees and the disciples, they were laughing at Jesus. You don't you know who that woman is? How dare that woman to be weeping on your feet? And who are you? And they were saying a whole lot. And Jesus just goes up and says, hey, I have a question for you. Amen. I have a question for you. He said, a man had two debtors. One owed him $1,000, the other one $2. And he write it off, forgave them. Right. Which of them will love the man most? He said, oh, the one that matches give. He said, you have answered right. I am in your house. You never bid me welcome. You never wash my feet. But this woman, who you are looking down upon, that is a prostitute. The time I came here, he was always at my feet. Simon, listen to me. Her sins, which are many, are forgiven her. She did something. And Ruth must do something. That's the bride. Must do something. Must defile every odd. And Boaz slept, and before he stretched out like this, a lady sleeping by his feet. Oh, that man is a just man. So, what's happening here? A lady at my feet. If people saw me, they would say, I'm a bad man. So he panicked. He said, cool down. I am Ruth. You are the kinsman. Woo! Call him back to the scriptures. You are the kinsman. I am a widow of your brother. Amen. You must redeem me. Oh, man. And Boaz couldn't argue. Said, I will do. And the Bible says he gave him 6 measures. Right. Go and wait upon that. That the 6 church ages. Yes. They have a measure of the word. Yes. Go and wait on that. Yes. Until I finish the work of redemption. Yes. Amen. Is that right? Yes. Until I finish it. Yes. And God gave the 6 church ages a measure of the word. Yes. And he went to the intercessory throne. Yes. To finish the work of redemption. Yeah. And when he finished, he moved out. Yeah. And when he moved out, amen. John was there weeping because he thought there's no hope. Yeah. And the elder said, John, hold it. The lion of the tribe of Judah has prevailed. Yeah. And he said, I turned to look, and here is a lamb. Yeah. Yeah. a bleeding lamb coming out with the blood, walked to the throne and took the book. Woo, brother, took the book and sat on the throne. Total authority and break the seals. And John, to the surprise of John, he said, come and see. Oh, man. Oh. John said the book, nobody could not even look at it. But this time was to go and take it. Oh, man. I feel religious now. Took the book. Amen. That which Adam rejected or forfeited. Amen. Now, remember when Adam listened to the wife and touched the tree of knowledge, good and evil? God said, I know Adam. If I didn't get rid of him here, he will go back to the tree of life and eat it. And he will live forever. That means the tree of life is powerful than the tree of knowledge, good and evil. Are you following me? Yes. I know Adam. Yes. And so he kicked him out of the presence of the Lord, put some cherubims and a flaming sword to keep the way of life. It doesn't matter what Adam has been. Right. If he can come back. Woo! And so our kinsman came and paid the price. Yes. And he walked to the throne and took that book of life. The book of redemption, that which Adam had forfeited. He said, my children, now you can come to it. Oh, man. Amen. Revelation 10. Go take the book and eat the book. Ah. See, the message supposed not to be just on papers and tapes. The message resting place is the heart of the believer. Amen. Are you catching what I mean? I know brother and Ben, good friend, and then I sent somebody coming to America. That when you come to America, go to Tennessee, Manchester. My friend Ben is there. This is the message. Go and give a brother Ben. The message and the messenger becomes one thing. Because he's looking for brother Ben. Is that right? And then he comes and delivers the message to Brother Ben. Trouble finish. If you got a hold of that message, it won't do you any good. Because the message is directed to Brother Ben. And when Brother Ben take that book, the Bible says, eat it. And John ate the book. So the book is no more just paper. The message of the hour is no more paper. It's now in the heart of the believer. Amen. I hope you get what I mean. It's in the heart of the believer. Now, if we go to the rapture, will the message books go? Will the Bible go? They will be here. But the word is gone. I hope you catch what I mean. The word is becoming flesh again. At the opening of the seventh seal, the full word of God is born into manifestation. In whose life, in whose human flesh is the bride? The word is born again in the heart of the believer. Amen. The word is living in flesh. Not papers. Let's stop the paper fighting. Amen. And take the word into our heart. Eat it, John. Eat it. It will be sweet in your mouth and bitter in your belly. And when you do, prophesy once again. I will ride this trail once again. Amen. But Abraham said, now the bride, the son of man, is in the bride form. I tell my church back home, the Antichrist can take the message and burn him, can take the whole Bible, we will still preach the message. Because the message now is in the heart of the believer. God did not intend his message to be on papers. That can be bent. He doesn't intend his words to remain on paper. No. It has to live in a human heart. Amen. Oh, I hope you catch what I mean. Amen. Ruth, wait till I finish the work. And he went right down. Oh, God help us. Ah, my time is going fast. He went right, and there was one man who seems to be closer than Boaz. So Boaz went to him, and he said he could not do it. He leave it for Boaz. Amen. We are sons of God. God is our Redeemer. But God as a spirit cannot redeem. So he has to come back to human flesh. So the office of the Father couldn't do it. He has to change the office to Boaz, a human flesh, to be able to give blood to deliver us. So perfectly. Amen. Amen. Boaz moved down there and make the proclamation. That's what I want you to look at tonight and take that to your heart. Boaz make a proclamation. Said, all that Naomi has lost, today I redeem. And moreover, the Moabitish woman that came with her, I marry to raise up seed upon the inheritance. He pronounced that word. And after the pronouncing, what happened? The invincible union. Amen. The invincible union. And that's where we are now. In the seventh seal, called the ministry of Christ and the ministry of Jesus, of the bride, is the same ministry. Amen. So Christ now in the bride form, in the invincible union, he has poured out himself into his beloved bride. They are one for the rapture. Oh man, at that day, you will know, I am in the Father, I in you, and you in me. What day? This day. Amen. And it all happened in the barley season. Oh man. Plenty of food. It was time the word was revealed. Plenty of food. You don't need to go hungry. Oh man. The mountain of blood in the west. Ooh. God, let me read the Bible and I leave you to go home. Kinsman Redeemer. Naomi and Ruth came in just at the barley season. The barley season was bread season. The season when flesh blood was being served. Flesh blood. Not Luther's message. Amen. Not Wesley message. Not a Pentecostal message. But the flesh blood. It's on the table. Amen. Flesh blood. And the church, in these last days, through 2,000 years of pagan teachings and things, has come in at barley season. Freshness of life. New bread. Only out of heaven. This is it. Bread from heaven. I am the bread of life. Your fathers eat manna and they are dead. And I am the bread of life that comes down from God out of heaven. And if a man eats this bread, he will never die. The church in these last days is here. It's brought right now at the barren season. The seals are open. The word is right here, the bread of life. Amen. Serving a flesh bread. Amen. That's your seventh seal. That's why there's trouble around it. It's not a public ministry. It's a ministry between Boaz and Ruth. Naomi even was not there. Amen. No more public show. Amen. The individual in union with Christ. United with him. Becoming one body. So the head and the body have become one unit. They are united. They are one. The word is in the bride. Oh, man. Brother Brown said, this is the secret. He said, the secret is the word is in the bride. She knows what to be done with the word. This is adoption time. Oh, man. See, realize who you are. Realize what God has done in you. And when you speak the word, don't doubt it. Amen. Because you are the bride of Christ. And the devil knows that. Oh, man. When you come to Africa, you see the power of this message. Oh, brother. You walk through where demonic powers, and this message go through just like that. One of the fetish priests who got converted, this old man, so much demonized, so strong, everybody fear him in the village. Powerful man, they call him. And I think when he was over 80 years, and I think he's realizing he needs God. Yes. So he went in to a Roman Catholic priest and told him that this is my issue. I have a lot of idols in the house, and I want if you can come and destroy them. And the Roman Catholic priest said, oh, don't worry. It's the same God. Only you are passing different ways. And that father never stepped there. So he went to a Pentecostal pastor, told him the issue. So, okay, I'll come. And that's the end. He never stepped there. So one brother was passing by when they were discussing. The brother moved. He said, what are you talking about? He said, okay, let me take you to my pastor. And he came to believe the message. So I just sent one minister and one deacon, go to the village there and get those things destroyed. Oh, wonderful. Wonderful. The power of the message. This man got an idol in a particular room. If you look at the face of the idol, you will fall down dead. So nobody goes down there. When he goes there, he has what he will say before he enters. And every year, he had the people, even some of our past presidents, they come together, they enter that room, they will cook things and do so many rituals. So when he told them, it's in this room, he told them, when you go knock, oh, brother said, when they were moving, he said, upstep. So when they were crawling, the deacon behind him jump and, bah, open the door. We would knock at who? He went and picked the demon, raised the idol. And the whole people in the village, they begin running. Nobody want to see it. And he come down and he throw it, bah, smash it on the ground. Break everything. Burn everything to ashes. And the people were wondering, who are these people? Where did they come from? These are the bride of Christ. Amen. They have the power of the king behind them. Amen. They don't walk just like man. The whole heaven is behind them. Oh, brother. One time I was burning some idols somewhere. And as I set the fire, the brother, the owner came to believe. So he was standing in amazement. So I said, brother, why? Are you not happy I'm burning them? He said, oh, pastor, not so. He said, these things can never be burned by fire. People try it and they are in trouble. So the way the fire is burning easy, I can't understand. I said, yes, the person who are standing here, that demon don't have power. And there was some spiritual church just in the stone throw. And the demon went into there and they begin speaking through the women. Hide us, we are being burned. Hide us, we are being burned. So the pastor told them, don't tell anybody what has happened here. But the church members, no. Some came around and said, what is happening here? Say, we were burning some idols. They said, oh, they are now in our church. Oh, my. The message is just powerful. Brother, when you storm among demons, they run away here and there. Amen. You are the bride of Christ. Amen. You are the fulfillment of the seventh seal. He is no more in heaven. He descended. Amen. When the seventh seal was opened, there was silence in heaven. Why silent? He is right down here. Amen. And we are in union with him. He is here. Where is he hiding? In the bride. In the body of believers. Jesus Christ, the same yesterday, today, and forever. Amen. So you see these three revivals? But thank God we are in the seventh seal revival. It's the going home of the bride. Our Lord is here, and he will never leave here alone. He take the bride away. You love the Lord tonight? Shall we be on our feet? Amen. Amazing grace. A song. Oh, that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost. God bless you. Beautiful.
What a masterpiece.
Amen. God bless you. Some fun.
I was blind, but now I see through many dangers, through many dangers.
Oh, the amazing grace of God.
And snares I had already come.
God bless our audience online. Two back in from Sunday morning.
Tis grace that